Good morning and welcome to this, my final service at St. Chad's. It's a very sad day for me because this is not the way I wanted to say goodbye to you all. I so wanted to meet with you and to tell you how much you have supported and loved me over the last 10 years and how much I have loved each one of you. It's been a difficult week and today's a very difficult day, so I hope you will manage to cope with my tears because I'm sure there will be some. A big thank you to everyone who has helped put this service together, to so many friends and colleagues. I will miss you all. Please do, if you can, join us for coffee after the service. It would be really good to see you then. So the Lord of mercy and love be with you. We come from scattered lives to meet with God. Let us recognize God's presence with us. As God's people, we have gathered in our homes to worship God. So let us do that today. God of our days and years, we set this time apart for you as we journey with you towards the cross and the empty tomb. Form us into your likeness so that our lives may glorify you. Amen. And so we have a piece of music now, sung by Linda Wainscott. Linda is the former director of the Diocesan Board of Education. And it was my privilege to work alongside her for, well, a large number of years, but for the last 3 years as she is director and I was chair. And during that time, Linda became not only my boss, but she was also became a very, very good friend. So thank you for this, Linda. I really do appreciate it.
One, you're my rock, oh.
thanks, Linda. Before we continue our service, I want to introduce Rod Smith to you. Rod is the church warden at St. Chad's, but he is so much more than that to me and to everyone here in the church. He does so much for the church and for the community. So I'd like to hand over to Rod now. Thank you, Rod.
Dear Elaine, how can we sum up 10 years of services that you have given in only a few words? All the things that you have done, not only for St. Chad's, but also for the community, and most of all, the village school as governor, and your involvement with St. Chad's Centre. You have given up so much time for the events like Messy Church, Craft Afternoons and Film Nights. What an act for us to follow. As chair of the PCC, you have contributed so much guidance and help. Personally, I shall sadly miss you, and I'm sure will many others. The contributions that you have had from Jim with the readings, music, etc. have been very supportive. We wish you a long, happy retirement, good luck, and God bless you both and your family. Rod.
Perfume poured out to prepare our Lord for his death. May the fragrance of Christ fill our church. May the fragrance of Christ fill our lives. God calls us to be a fragrant offering to his glory. Let us call to mind the way our living exudes the odour of death. We are often slow to follow the example of Christ. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. We often fail to be known as Christ's disciples. Christ, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. We often fail to walk the way of the cross. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God, who sent his Son into the world to save sinners, bring you his pardon and his peace, now and forever. Amen. Now, when Sophia heard I was retiring, she offered to sing. Many of you will have heard her sing at Christmas time, and I am so grateful to this talented young woman for the gift that she offers to me today, her wonderful voice. So over to you, Sophia.
Thank you.
And so the collect for this, the second Sunday of Lent. Almighty God, you show to those who are in error the light of your truth, that they may return to the way of righteousness. Grant to all those who are admitted into the fellowship of Christ's religion, that they may reject those things that are contrary to their profession, and follow all such things are as agreeable to the same, through our Lord Jesus Christ, who is alive and reigns with you, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and for ever. Amen. Before our gospel reading, I'd like to introduce you to Ros Pratt. Ros was an important part of our congregation, along with her husband John, who was a retired priest, and he was such a huge help when I came to the parish. His was one of the most difficult funerals that I've ever taken, because he was such a lovely man, and it's so nice to be able to invite Ros back. I know she's not here actually physically in St. Chad's, but it is so kind of her to come and to read our gospel for us today. Thank you so much, Ros.
Hear the gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to Mark. Glory to you, O Lord. Then he began to teach them that the Son of Man must undergo great suffering and be rejected by the elders, the chief priests and the scribes, and be killed, and after 3 days rise again. He said all this quite openly, and Peter took him aside and began to rebuke him. But turning and looking at his disciples, he rebuked Peter and said, "Get behind me, Satan, for you are setting your mind not on divine things, but on human things." He called the crowd with his disciples and said to them, "If any want to become my followers, let them deny themselves and take up their cross and follow me. For those who want to save their life will lose it, and those who lose their life for my sake and for the sake of the gospel will save it. For what will it profit them to gain the whole world and forfeit their life? Indeed, what can they give in return for their life? Those who are ashamed of me and of my words in this adulterous and sinful generation, of them the Son of Man will also be ashamed when he comes in the glory of his Father with the holy angels." This is the gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, O Christ.
May I speak in the name of God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. It seems quite fitting, really, that as today is my final service, we should be in Lent, a time when we think of Jesus journeying to the cross. Today is the end of our journey together as we have shared experiences, shared our gifts, celebrated our joys, comforted one another in our sorrows, and generally have grown together over the last 10.5 years. It's the end of one journey, but it's also the start of another. For me and Jim, as we start retired life together in the Northeast. For you, as you face a period of vacancy, and then a new journey with a new priest, a journey that will, I'm sure, be very different, but that I am confident God will bless you as St. Chad's continues to grow and develop. In our reading today, Jesus tells us that we must take up our cross and follow him. I must admit, being here at St. Chad's, sharing ministry with you, has never felt like a heavy cross to bear. Yes, there have been difficult times, building the centre and all the problems that caused, dealing with the theft of lead from the roof on more than one occasion, and both those things have brought their challenges, but together We've worked hard, we've prayed together, and we've achieved our objectives. For me, that's the most important thing about ministry, working together for the good of this congregation and this community. And I think that we have done that successfully. The connection with our church school continues to go from strength to strength. When I first came, Andy was the head, Vera was our foundation governor, then she was ably followed by Jane Everett. And over the years, we formed a really excellent working relationship. Now we have Mrs. Kilby and Sharon, a new foundation governor, working together to ensure the link between church and school goes from strength to strength. Working with the wonderfully gifted and talented individuals that are the staff at Bishop's Tachbrook CME Church of England School, and with the amazing children, and each one of them has been a joy to work with, has been a highlight of my ministry here. One that's very difficult to let go of, to be honest, but let go I must, and I will miss you all dreadfully. Not long after I arrived, I met with Bishop Christopher to discuss how my previous experience as a teacher and as a school chaplain could best be utilised in the Diocese of Coventry. He suggested I might like to join the Diocesan Board of Education. And that was the beginning of a wonderful collaboration with the board and the staff of the DBE, which ended in September when I stepped down as chair. It was such a privilege to work with Canon Linda Wainscott. As you remember, she sang for us at the beginning of the service. To work with every member of the board of the diocese, of the Board of Education, and latterly, the privilege of being its chair. I worked with a wonderful team in the diocese, led by Linda and now being led by April. And each member of that team brought so many gifts to bear so that all the schools in this diocese continue to thrive and flourish. It was a privilege to be in right at the very beginning of the Diocesan Multi-Academy Trust, and it's been fantastic to see how that has gone from strength to strength. It's been wonderful to see other Multi-Academy Trusts growing in the diocese, some not too far away from here. And I have met, through working with the DBE, some inspirational head teachers, some wonderful teachers, and some very, very talented young people. I am so grateful to Bishop Christopher, to Linda, to April, and the team for putting their trust in me. So back to St. Chad's. We have worked so hard here to keep the building in relatively good order. And I hope we finally solved the roofing problem for the next couple of hundred years, I hope. Most of the work from the previous quinquennial has been done, and been done to a good degree. I am sorry that I need to leave you with the list from this quinquennial, which was only carried out in the summer. But I'm afraid that's the joy of having a 12th century church. The work on the building never ends. But please do remember that although this is an absolutely staggeringly beautiful church, the church is more than the building. I think that's something that we have all learned from having our lead stolen, and how we have continued as a community during lockdown. This parish and community is something to really treasure. Look how many people came together to make sure we had our own Tommy back in 2018. And then in 2019, how people from all walks of our community dug deep to help raise money for the roof. Not just Christians, but our local Sikh friends and also our local Muslim community. And for that, I am so, so grateful. I'm also pleased that the work on the roof has been completed before I left. I'm not so pleased that it cost us almost double what we thought at the beginning because of the problems with coping stones that cost us an extra £27,000. But I have been humbled by the love and generosity of so many people for this church and for what it stands for in the community. And I hope that is something that will continue after I've gone, because this community is worth standing alongside and being with. They might not all come to church, but they love their church in Bishop's Tachbrook. As a congregation, you've been open to many new things that this weird woman has brought before you. And for that, I'm not only grateful, but I'm confident that you will be open to new possibilities and new opportunities for mission and ministry when your new priest arrives. We have tried different types of worship within the church and using the St. Chad Centre. Our breakfast church was a great success, and I'm sorry that it's had to stop because of lockdown. We had a couple of really good big breakfasts too for Christian Aid, and they were well supported. Thank you, Carl and Fiona, for the amazing catering. Festivals have always been well supported in St. Chad's, and thanks must go to Tachbrook Brownies and their leaders for the help over the years. They always turned out in force for Harvest, Remembrance, Christingle and Mothering Sunday. And they were always willing to join in. Carols on the Green, Carols in the Leopard were always fun. And thanks to Joe and Jim for the musical accompaniment. As a priest, one of the real privileges of ministry is being able to take baptisms, weddings and funerals. In terms of baptisms, it's been wonderful for me to be able to baptise so many children from the village. Some of these children have been admitted to communion before confirmation, and boy, were those lessons fun. Confirmations have also been wonderful, with the last group designing their own altar frontal, showing their journey of faith. However, I think one of the highlights of my ministry was the confirmation of Mark, Ken and Jean, all octogenarians. I know Bishop Christopher also remembers it well. Sadly, Mark and Ken died within a few days of one another. Jean is now in a nursing home and very poorly, and so your prayers for her and her family will be, I'm sure, much appreciated. Taking funerals, whether of members of the congregation like Mark and Ken, or wonderful people of our community, has always been a privilege. Each different and each as unique as the person being commended to God. Some have been more difficult than others, but each one very special. It's been wonderful to sit and walk alongside people, to laugh and to cry with them. I've also been very privileged to celebrate the lives of those who've been cremated at Oakley Wood. Until recent events curtailed this, every 4 months, a memorial service was held at the Crem, where people's names were read out and wildflowers, well, the seeds of wildflowers, given to the bereaved. It was an ecumenical service, and it was wonderful to stand alongside Roman Catholic, Methodist, and humanist colleagues. They were always memorable occasions. And so to weddings. Wow, we had some amazing weddings. Can you all remember the beautiful flowers that adorned the church after Gemma and Andrew's wedding? We've had a couple of wonderful international weddings with prayers in German and granddads flying in from the Punjab in full Sikh dress. Of course, there was the biker wedding and the wedding of two wonderful cab leaders. But every wedding that I have taken has been a joy, and it's been great when those couples have then brought their children to be baptised. It's something I'm going to really miss. But I'm so pleased that just after the first lockdown, I was able to marry Nicky, and it was just lovely because it was a church family. One of the biggest encouragements to me over the last 10 years has been the ways in which I have seen people grow in their faith and use the gifts and skills which God has given them. I know that some of you have been able to do things that you never thought were possible, and that has been great to see. There are so many gifts that God has given to you all as a congregation and as a community, and seeing you grow and develop in those gifts gives me a huge sense of excitement and great hope for the future of St. Chad's. Journeys are not always easy, and many of you have been on a journey with this church for a very long time. You have seen priests come and go. You have seen people come and go. You've seen births, marriages, and deaths. You've seen young people grow up, move off to university. You've seen older people move away. But your faith has remained strong and has grown. You are a church that welcomes people in, as you have welcomed Jim, Adam, Owen, Luke, and I, and many others who are watching today. But most importantly, I believe that you are a church who seeks the kingdom of God, and that you are a people who will take up your cross to ensure that God's kingdom will continue to grow in this place, at this time, and into the future. Our journey together has come to an end, but an exciting new journey awaits you as a church, as a community, you as individuals, us as a family. We will now step out and be whatever God calls us to be. May God richly bless each of us as we take one more step along the way. Amen. We confess our faith in the words of the Creed. We believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, of one being with the Father, through hope all things were made. For us, and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, was incarnate from the Holy Spirit and the Virgin Mary, and was made man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day, he rose again. In accordance with the scripture, he ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is worshipped and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. So Kieron is going to sing for us now, and he is going to sing one of my favourite hymns, Guide Me, O Thou Great Redeemer. I would like to thank Kieron for the support that he has been during lockdown and during the time that the church has been worshipping online. His voice has been an inspiration for many. So thank you, Kieron, for your time and your effort. And I thank God for the gift of your beautiful voice. So over to Kieron.
For the church and for the world, and let us thank God for his goodness. We pray for the Christian church throughout the world, and we pray for our bishops Christopher and John as they lead this diocese through very difficult times. Today we pray especially for Elaine, who has ministered to us here in Bishop's Tachbrook faithfully over the past 10 years. We thank you, Father, for her many gifts which have enriched us, and her time which she has given unstintingly to the church, the school, and the whole parish. We thank you especially for her skills in putting together imaginative online services and navigating us through this past 12 months of COVID restrictions. As she begins her retirement tomorrow, may she find refreshment, relaxation, and the joy of being with Jim and her family again. Lord, hear us. Lord, graciously hear us. And today we give thanks for medical workers, vaccinators, scientists, and politicians as the way forward out of COVID restrictions is rolled out. In this impatient world, we pray for the gift of patience and consideration towards others over the coming months, so that we may achieve a successful outcome. Lord, hear us. Lord, graciously hear us. And Lord, we thank you for all who, through good relationships, have shown us your love, for all whom we love and all who love us. We pray for your blessing on the couples preparing to be married here at St. Chad's this year. And we also remember those who are struggling in their relationships. May you light up their way. Lord, hear us. Lord, graciously hear us. And we now hold before you, in the quietness of our hearts, all we know who are sick in body or mind. And let us name them before God. God knows their needs, and we pray that they will receive the healing from him which is right for each one of them. Lord, hear us. Lord, graciously hear us. And let us now bring before you those who have died and are in your nearer presence. We ask for your peace and love for those who mourn their passing. Lord, hear us. Lord, graciously hear us. We give thanks for the example of Jesus, who was obedient even to death on a cross, and who strengthens and inspires us in all goodness. Merciful Father, accept these prayers for the sake of your Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Amen.
Thank you, Jenny, for those intercessions. And now a few words from Richard Suffern. Some very kind words, actually, that I much appreciate from Richard, who is the vicar or the rector of St. Margaret's Whitnash, but he's also now our area dean. And I'd like to thank Richard because he has walked alongside me so often during the past 10 years. I'd also like to say thank you to his wife, Jackie, who's also been a really good friend.
Well, hello, St. Chad's, Bishop's Tachbrook. Hello, Elaine and Jim and all who are watching this little clip. This is the occasion, I understand, of the farewell service for you, Elaine, at the end of your ministry at St. Chad's. And on behalf of the Deanery of Warwick and Leamington, which of course encompasses Bishop's Tachbrook, I'd like to just say a big thank you very much to you, Elaine, for your ministry in Tachbrook at St. Chad's, which has been a blessing to so many. And not only within the parish, but also in the wider diocese as well. Thank you very much for what you have given to the wider diocesan family, especially, for example, through chairing the Diocesan Board of Education. And your experience in the area of education and teaching has been invaluable. And I know that with your guiding influence, the DBE has thrived, as indeed has the church community at St Chad's. So thank you to you and those who have worked with you at St Chad's over the years that you have been there. Thank you very much for what you've contributed to the Deanery, which has enriched our lives together as a church family in this area. Also like to extend a thank you to Jim as well. And on occasions when I've been to St Chad's and Jim has been there and playing his guitar, that's been great and has really helped us in our worship as well. So we'd like to just pray for God's blessing upon you as you retire. And I know that you won't be retiring into inactivity, but into whatever God has got for you in the future as you head north. May you and Jim and family be greatly blessed, and thank you for what you have left with us here by way of memories, but not just memories, but also active service of the Lord in this area, which has enriched our lives in the past, in the now, and will continue to do so in the future. Thank you. May God bless you, and may I now just pray for you and the church community at St Chad's. Dear God, thank you so much for Elaine and Jim, for their ministry at Tachbrook, and Lord, for Elaine as she completes her time as vicar in St Chad's. May she move on from here, knowing that she has completed what you have called her to do, and confident that the church is in good hands, and most of all in your hands, for a future, we pray, which will be greatly blessed. And on the building blocks which Elaine and team and others working with her have been working and praying towards, will you, Lord, please continue to build your good work and lay the way and pave the way for future ministry at St Chad's. So, Lord, we look back with thanksgiving and we look forward with hope for the community at St Chad's and Tachbrook, and also for Elaine herself in the future that you have for her and for Jim in life and in ministry. May they have many good times and more time with family to share and celebrate and to know your goodness and to know fulfillment in your service. For this I ask, praying the blessing of God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit upon you, Elaine, and upon your church family there, the church family of which you will always be part, and although separate geographically, may you continue in heart and mind to be in fellowship with the Lord, who is always with us wherever we are. For this we ask in Jesus' name. Amen.
Where Christ walks, we will follow. Where Christ stumbles, we will stop. Where Christ cries, we will listen. Where Christ suffers, we will hurt. When Christ dies, we will bow our heads in sorrow. When Christ rises again in glory, we will share his endless joy. There is no other way. He is the only way. Now I'd like to hand over to Jenny and Peter Lister, again retired priests who live in the village and who have been such a massive support to me over the past 10 years, along with Christine Pollard, who's also always been there if I've needed her. And then after Jenny and Peter's blessing, Tom will play a hymn that was sung at my ordination 20 years ago.
Elaine, may the strength of God pilot you. May the power of God preserve you. May the wisdom of God instruct you. May the hand of God protect you. And may the way of God direct you. May the shield of God defend you. and may the host of God guard you.
And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit guide you on your journey at every change and turn, and be with you this day and forevermore. Amen.
Blessing for you all. Christ give you grace to grow in holiness, to deny yourselves, take up your cross and follow him. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son and the Holy Spirit be among you, be with those you pray for, those you love, this day and always. Amen. Go in peace to love and serve the Lord. In the name of Christ. Amen. Once again, thank you all for being with me to this morning. Do join us for coffee. If you don't know how to do that, then give me a ring on 077-66083-666 and I'll send you the link. God bless.
massive thank you to Nicky for playing one of my favourite hymns of all time. I absolutely love that hymn, and to do it as she did is absolutely wonderful, and I thank her for taking the time and the effort to arrange it and record it. I'd like to finish now with Sophia singing another song for us. It's a Maori folk song, and it is stunningly beautiful. Thank you so much for recording this, Sophia.
Do you want?